Hello, welcome back to Bolt Action CP for a special edition battle report. Tonight we got Steve and Andre in the house, and we're doing a three-player game, all against each other, in a mission that Andre designed, and we've kind of modified on the fly a little bit. So we're doing 750 points, early war. So no big HE flying around, except Steve did bring a heavy mortar, but he wasn't in on that. So he didn't know about it. That's all right. But it allowed him to take it, though, in his early war thing. So
and that works.
Yeah, so there you go. Well, he can bring a KV-2 in his early war list. If he brought one of those, we'd be in trouble, but get your crowbars out. So the mission is, so we have three objectives, one in the center, one over there, and one there, all along the center line. The middle one's worth 2 points, and the two ones on each side are worth 1 point. And to claim them, you can claim them by touching them, and then if you move away, you still hold it until an enemy touches it, and then they hold it. And then whoever holds it, whoever has control of it at the end of the turn gets points, and they just you tally them up at the end, so you keep track of how many points you hold at the end of every turn and get that amount of points. And deployment wise it's going to be I forgot what they call it in the rule book, like disorganized or random, yeah, or something. Well, it's where you come in on an edge, and once a unit comes in on that edge, another unit's not allowed to come on that edge. They have to come in on a different edge. We're going to change that a little bit by making it, you can't come in on an edge that's been used the past two edges. So we'll see how that works. We had a hard time keeping track of one edge. So keeping track of two might be even harder. But that's it. That's the mission.
Also, kill point for each unit destroyed.
Right. And every unit you kill is another point. So it'd probably be a good idea to keep someone around the objectives if you want to hold them. Okay, so that's the mission, and we'll go over to the forces. Right, so here's my 750 early war Germans. I got three squads of regular guys, 2 9-man, 1 8-man, and they have a SMG squad leader and an LMG. I got my 6-man veteran pioneers with flamethrower, my medium machine gun, got a light mortar, anti-tank rifle, light anti-tank gun, motorcycle, and my officer with SMGs.
The British are coming in with a tank. I got a proxy there. That's actually an A9 Mark I. So it has a light anti-tank gun and two side turret medium machine guns and a coax machine gun. So I've got front and left arc and front and right arc on the two side turrets. Everyone is regular. I've got 2 10-man squads and 3 5-man squads, a medium machine gun, a first lieutenant with another guy, and 2 Brens, both with a forward-facing LMG and a pintle-mounted LMG.
So the Soviet forces, we have a heavy mortar with a spotter. We have a proxy for a BA-10 armored car with coaxial machine gun and hull-mounted machine gun and a light anti-tank. We have 2 inexperienced LMG squads. We have 1 regular Siberian squad, tough fighters, and 1 LMG. We've got a ZIS divisional gun, a senior lieutenant with his buddy, inexperienced, free inexperienced squad, and 2 trucks with pintle mounted medium machine guns.
All right, so those are the forces. So the name of the rule I was forgetting was Confused Fight. And also Andre is not bringing this free observer at 750. So that'll be helpful to me or Steve or both of us if we are fighting each other and he drops it on us. So anyway, we'll go ahead and do turn 1 because there's no deployment It'll be back when turn truck one's died. Over. Truck dies. All right, so turn one is now over. It's going to be tough to recap, I think, because there's so much happening with three different armies all coming in from all different table edges. So I guess we'll just go by table edge. So we'll start over here. Steve brought his heavy mortar on. And then a few turns later, Andre brought that five-man squad in, fired and killed one of the crew, put a pin on him. I ran that squad on. And Steve brought the divisional gun on. I also brought my light mortar on and fired on that squad, inexperienced squad of Russians there. They had come on over here. He ran the truck up. So you're keeping track of your objective points. All right, so he's got Steve claimed it in the truck. And then I came on after that behind him, and I fired and I caught the truck on fire. And he failed his morale check, so he ran off the board, or the crew ran out. So the guys just got out right there and went down. And my light mortar that I fired missed. Andre brought Vickers on. Couldn't fire, but he's lined up there. I brought my anti-tank rifle on there. And Andre brought in two of his 10-man squads here and his lieutenant. On this board edge, I ran in a squad. And then right behind him came a Russian squad who fired and killed two of them, put a pin on them. And I think that's it. The rest of the stuff's all in reserve, so it's going to get really crowded on the board here soon. It's going to get bloody and crowded. So that's it for turn one, so we'll go ahead and do turn two. All right, turn two is over now. So do the same thing as last time, and we'll start just on an edge. So over here on this edge, Steve had his divisional gun right there.
Right here.
Yeah, it was there. Not there anymore. We'll get to that. He fired, my squad advanced up into those trees trying to get out of line of sight of the thing, but didn't make it. And he fired and landed the template on him. It killed two of them, but he still put three pins on. And my light mortar just ran up. Then Andre brought his cruiser or whatever the hell, Crusader.
A9 Mark 1
with all the machine guns and hosed down. He got behind the gun shield and took out the divisional gun. Over here is a big firefight developing way far away from all the objectives, so I don't know what's going on over here, but it's like a bloodlust or something happening. But so let's see, we got the truck came in, took out a couple of the squad in the trees, and then the other guys got out, the Siberians. The squad in the trees went down, they killed another one, so they're down to three. And then Andre brought his Bren in and fired that, and the guys got out and fired on the Siberians, so they're down to five guys. He did kill the sergeant. And then Steve's officer came in and whiffed on the guys in the trees because they were down. Over here on this side, Andre's Vickers fired on my squad and killed, I think, one of them or two of them. And then they had attempted to advance and failed their order, so they went down. My motorcycle came in, tried to fire on the inexperienced, and they went down. But I still killed three of them, I believe. I think that's it for that. So on this side, my MG42... ran into the building. My officer ran up there. My anti-tank rifle ran up there. Andre, this squad advanced and fired needing sevens and put a pin on the MMG, which I think is probably gonna come back to haunt me. Usually those kind of offhand pins they just don't think about wind up doing something big time.
Used to be a Soviet squad.
Yep, we'll get there. this squad ran up, claimed the objective. Over here, so he had that inexperienced squad, kind of in between those squads. He fired on my squad. We went down. We're down to, five guys. I lost a few guys. He put a pin. My engineer squad passed order, came on, missed with the flamethrower, but the four submachine guns took out seven of the inexperienced guys, needing twos and threes. Steve's mortar did fire and missed that squad. And I brought my light AT gun in over here to try to maybe hopefully get a shot on that tank next turn. So I think that's it. That officer, British officer, ran up, so he's right there. So that's it for turn two. So I'll be back at the end of turn three. All right, here we are at the end of turn three. We'll start off on this side. I guess we start off right here because at the beginning of the game, Andre got like four die in a row, or three or four die in a row, and he wind up, he took out everything of Steve's.
Mortar, officer, and Siberian squad.
And truck.
Yeah.
So he pretty much decimated Steve over here. This squad, they were kind of in the trees, or they were in the trees. And this tank advanced up. I had put my light AT gun in ambush, waiting, and he missed. Blew his chance to shoot the tank. The tank fired on these guys, and he killed one. And they tried to rally in Fubard and moved back. My mortar moved up, fired on his officer, who had gone up in there and claimed the objective, and missed. On this side, Steve's armored car came in and totally whiffed on everything. I think he put a pin.
Put one pin on Andre.
A pin, yeah. I missed the Bren with the AT gun, machine gun those guys, and missed. Or he one pin. Over here, my motorcycle killed three more of those inexperienced. They're still there. They got four pins on them. This squad failed their order again, so they went down. The Vickers took out my officer. They were in the open right there. Wiped them out. My MG42 failed in order with one pin, just as I predicted it would. And so I haven't really moved over here at all. He has two 10-man regular squads here, untouched. They ran up there. One of them went on ambush there. Over here, I just ran my Pioneer squad up. That squad rallied. These guys, the Vickers came on, and the squad got out and both fired everything at the Pioneer squad. Put two pins on them. And Steve's inexperienced squad failed to come in. So that's it for turn three. Andre's clearly handling the game right now. He's got the middle objective. Forgot to mention his officer took that. He got two of the middle. He's got that one. And he's got all those kill points. And I got, two kill points and no objectives. So there's not much hope for me and Steve unless we get a lot of dice early and roll really well, which isn't unheard of.
Andre's got 9 points. You and I have two each.
Sweet.
Ooh.
Isn't that how you started that last turn?
2-9.
No, didn't you get one more point for...
Oh, I'm sorry. I have three. Yeah.
Yeah, okay, yeah. You got an objective point.
1 point closer. All right. Be back at the end of turn four. All right. Welcome back. Now we're finished with turn four. You can see there's a lot less everything except British on the board right now.
No, there's one less British.
One less British.
I lost a die.
You did?
Yeah.
Oh, the Bren. Okay. So we'll start over here. So I had that squad that Fubard last time move back, and I had my mortar. That tank drove up. I actually fired at the tank before he moved, but missed with my door knocker. And then he mowed down everyone over here, unfortunately. Over here, Steve did kill something. finally. he killed the brand carrier, and he machine gunned that squad, but I think he didn't do anything. They were able to run that direction. The squad failed their order yet again. That's three turns in a row now with one pin failed. My motorcycle did hose down the killed three more of the inexperienced Russians that were on the objective and finally made them run off when they had five pins. Over here, Steve got his last reserve squad in, advanced into the crater and unloaded on the Vickers, but they went down. He's experienced, so by the time it was all said and done, he needed seven, and he missed. My MG42, again, failed the order. So he didn't do anything. These two squads just advanced up. Actually, that squad's on ambush, right?
Yeah.
You want to try to get them out of there? Or?
No, they're staying on ambush.
So they're going to stay on ambush, all right. Back on this side, his Bren and his squad. The Bren, I think, fired on the veterans, put another pin. The squad, I think, also fired on them.
No, they fired on the
On the regular squad. Killed one of them, or two of them. That's right. So I'm down to that. They passed the regular squad, passed order, fired back, killed one of the British regulars. And the Pioneer squad just rallied. So that's it. We're getting really thin. Steve and I are getting very thin on dice. So that's Andre's dice pool there, or all his kills. And I got three red dice, and Steve has one one British dice. So clearly, Andre is going to win this game, because I have nothing left, except one squad that just doesn't seem to want to move. So, and Steve only has...
two dice?
Yeah, Steve has an inexperienced squad he can't hit. And this truck over here, or it's a BA-10, whatever the hell it is. So anyway, that's it for turn four. So we'll go on to turn five. This might be the last turn, because the way things are going, Steve and I might not have anything left. So we'll be back at the end of turn five. So that was the end of turn five, and Steve and I have both agreed to surrender to Andre. Because there's just, we don't have any punch left at all. On this side, I did an advance up and fired the flamethrower and all my SMGs, and they still have four guys out of five. How is that possible? I only killed one guy with all the SMGs and the flamethrower, and then they passed their morale test. And I even shot, these guys shot over here, and I think we took out a couple of them, or one of them. But he still got 19 or 20 guys on the road, and he still has that objective with his officer. Over here, his squad ran up there, and then took fire from the BA-10, which only killed one, I think. This squad finally passed their order, and they advanced and fired on those guys too. They wound up having two pins, and they actually failed an order, so they were down. Oh, that's why the BA-10 didn't do that well, because they were down. And my motorcycle foobarred and rolled a four, so he just reversed out, went down. Over here, Andre spun around his Vickers. Fired, killed a couple of these guys, put a pin on them.
One inexperienced.
That's right, killed one guy, put a pin on them, and then they failed their order. So he was going to, Steve was going to assault, and then he couldn't pass the order with one die. My machine gun finally passed their order, and they fired on the guys in the open there.
Put a pin on them.
And just put a pin on them. That was it. So, I mean, it was basically total domination by the British. Even when Steve and I kind of semi-quasi agreed to team up, well, it didn't work last long.
Kicked my ass off the objective.
Well, as soon as I said let's team up on Andre, I fired on Steve with my motorcycle. So that truce didn't last long. So anyway, Andre had 19 points.
I had 6.
Steve had 6, and I had 3. And that was the accumulation from kill points and holding objectives per turn. So, I like the mission. I think it could use some tweaks. Like Steve was saying, maybe you can't come in on the same side within a certain amount, 12 inches. Because at one point we had a German squad, a Russian squad, and another German squad, you know, all right behind each other, shooting at each other. So that was kind of weird. And same thing over here. And right here where that tank came in point blank and just shot up that AT gun from behind the gun shield. So there probably should be some kind of minimum range you can be from an enemy when you come in. So anyway, we'll think about that. Probably make some adjustments to this and maybe try it again next time that all three of us are playing. So that's it. Andre, decisive victory for the British. And we'll be back next time.